afternoon, ma'am.
What did we learn in the last class?
Wind.
The poem Wind. Did we complete it?
No.
No. Then how many lines?
8 lines. We learned?
Yes. First 8 lines. Okay. Do you remember about the author? Who is the author? Sorry, who is the poet?
Subramanya.
Subramanya Bharati. And the, what are the details that you remember about him?
He was born on 11th December 1889.
Okay. Dates are not so important, but you just tell me, who was he? Which were the names that he was popular about?
Mahakavi.
Mahakavi Bharati. Yes.
Subramanya Bharati was a Tamil poet who was popularly known as Mahakavi Bharati. Then.
Veerakavi.
Veerakavi.
Shaktidasan.
Shaktidasan, Selidasan, and so on. And he was popular in various fields like
freedom fighter.
Freedom fighter.
Teacher.
Teacher.
Patriot.
Patriot.
Journalist.
Journalist. Then poet.
Ma'am, he was pioneer in modern Tamil poetry.
Yes. He was a pioneer of modern Tamil poetry and one of the prominent literary figures of all times. And the Wind was originally written, the poem Wind was originally written in which language?
Tamil.
Tamil language. And who is the translator?
A.K. Ramanujan.
A.K. Ramanujan. Okay. That much you remember. And then, what is the poet is trying to convey through the poem Wind? What is the style of the poem?
Commanding.
No, style. In which style this poem has been written?
Conversational style.
Yes. Poem is written in a conversational style. Then, what is the tone of the poet?
Commanding.
Commanding. Yeah. The poet has got an authoritative or commanding tone. Then, who is the speaker in the poem? Who is the speaker? The poem is written in a conversational form, which means somebody is talking to someone. So, who is the speaker?
Author.
The poet. The poet is a speaker. And to whom he is speaking?
To the wind.
Hmm?
The wind.
Yes, the poet is speaking to the wind. Okay, all right. So I'll quickly read those few lines. Wind, come softly. Don't break the shutters of the windows. Don't scatter the papers. Don't throw down the books on the shelf. There, look what you did. You threw them all down. You tore the pages of the books. You brought rain again. You're very clever at poking fun at weaklings. So the poet is a speaker and he is speaking to wind. And he is not making any request or he is not pleading, but he is commanding. The tone of the poet is authoritative. Which are the lines that shows the poet is commanding to the wind? Pick out the lines.
Don't break the shutters of the
wind. Don't break the shutters of the windows.
Don't scatter the papers.
Don't throw down the books on the shelf. Yes. Good. So in the first few lines, we find that the poet is commanding to the wind, just like a parent commands to his child. Okay. The parents do give a lot of instructions or advices to the child. Similarly, the poet is commanding or instructing the wind not to do this and not to do that. And there, look what you did. You threw them all down. You tore the pages of the books. You brought rain again. So here we find the wind with the nature of a teenager. The teenagers not like advices to be given. Teenagers are sometimes rebellious. They wanted to make their own decisions. Am I right? Do you agree with my statement?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, more or less. More or less. Teenagers wanted to make their own decisions. At this point of time, teenagers will not listen to anybody else, either to the parents or to the teachers or to elders. So they have their own point of view. So here, Wind is portrayed as a teenager or a young boy or girl who is very energetic, at times violent and even can cause some kind of destruction. Okay, so these lines show that wind has got the nature of a teenager. So the poet says, there, look what you did. You threw them all down. So the wind is not ready to listen to any of the commands given by the poet. The wind has thrown the books down from the shelf. It has torn the pages of the books, and it has also brought rain again. You're very clever at poking fun at weaklings. All these lines we have already discussed. Okay, I'm just recapitulating. Weaklings. What do you mean by weaklings? Weaklings.
Weak people.
Yes, weak people. And what do you understand by the phrase poking fun at? Poking fun at?
Making fun of.
Yes, making fun of. You're very clever at making fun of the weak people. So, do you remember the images which I showed you in the previous class? Which were the pictures that I showed you?
Dead books, old books.
Yes. I showed you the images of a broken window, then the pages scattering on the floor, then the images of the books, which are on the floor, then torn pages. Yes, the pages which have come out of the book, and so on. Okay, these all images you forgot. So what is the reason why the wind was able to destroy all these things? What is the reason?
Because they were weak.
Because?
Because these things were weak.
Yes, very good. Because these things were weak. The papers scattered onto the floor just because no weight has been kept on top of it. The windows were broken because those windows were old and weak in nature. Again, we find the doors were in a broken condition because it was weak. Okay, so if I compare the word old with that of weak, then the word new will be equated with?
Strong.
Very good, perfect. So here, the word old means weak, then the word new can be equated with strong. So wind always makes fun of the weak people. The paper get scattered because it was weak. The windows got broken because it was weak and old. Okay, so it is a common nature of the wind to make fun of the weak people. So I hope this portion is clear to you. Shall we move to this portion? The remaining lines?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Geraldine, read the next four lines.
Frail, crumbling houses, crumbling doors, crumbling rafters, crumbling bodies, crumbling life, crumbling hearts. The wind god winnows and crushes them all.
All right. Frail, crumbling houses, crumbling doors, crumbling rafters, crumbling wood, crumbling bodies, crumbling lives, crumbling hearts. The wind god winnows and crushes them all. Do you find anything common in those lines? Any particular word is repeated?
Crumbling.
Yes. Perfect. Crumbling. We find that same word has been repeated 7 or 8 times. What do you mean by crumbling?
Crumbling.
What do you mean by crumbling? Crumbling houses.
Destroying.
Destroying or falling apart. Destroying or falling apart. Crumbling. Broken into pieces. Okay, crumbling. And do you find any other word just in front of crumbling?
Frail.
Very good. What do you mean by frail?
Weak or delicate.
Yes. Frail means weak or delicate. So now let's come to the lines again. Let's check out the meaning. Frail, crumbling houses, crumbling doors, crumbling rafters, crumbling wood, crumbling bodies, crumbling lives, crumbling hearts. Everything has been crumbled by whom? By whom?
By
the wind, God.
By the wind, yes. Everything has been crumbled by the wind. And how this wind was able to destroy these things? Or what is the reason why the wind was able to destroy or crumble?
Because these things were weak or
decayed. Yes. Wonderful. Perfect, Srihari. Because these things were weak in its nature. Frail, crumbling houses. So the poet is trying to tell us that the wind is an expert in destroying or distracting the things which are weak. And which are the things here mentioned? The houses. The wind destroys the houses which are weak and old. The wind destroys the doors which are weak and old. And rafters. What do you mean by rafters? Rafters.
Board like things. Okay.
Sloping beam
support. Yes, sloping beam on the roof. A sloping beam which supports the roof. I'll show you the picture so that you will get a perfect idea. Okay, so here the poet says that the wind destroys everything that is weak. So here we can see the image of a broken window. Okay, different images of broken window. Wind can easily destroy once the things become very old and weak. And here we have the image of a house. Look at this house. Is it old or new?
Old.
Old.
Old or new?
It's old.
Yes, this house is very old. And it is about to get collapsed. And here, another house. Very old one. Isn't it? Very old in its nature. Then, what do you see? Image of a?
Old door.
Broken door. This was broken only because it was old. And now here we have the image of rafter. Rafter means sloping beams which support the roof. Okay. Is this old or new? Is this old?
That's new.
Is this old or new?
New.
New. These rafters are new. So will the wind be able to destroy it?
No, ma'am.
No. When things are new and strong, the wind will not be able to destroy. Then the poet says, crumbling wood. What do you mean by wood here?
Trees.
Yes, wood refers to trees. The trees falls apart very fast if they are weak. You can see if the trees roots are not strongly binded in the soil, then they will fall apart very soon in the harsh wind. Then crumbling bodies. Bodies means? Please unmute and respond. I know that some of you are sitting and moving your lips, but I can't hear. You have muted. Unmute and respond. Bodies. Bodies means? Human beings. Human beings. Me and you. Each one of us. If we are not physically strong also, wind can easily pull us out. Then crumbling lives and crumbling hearts. Again, look at the terms used by the poet. Hearts. Crumbling lives and crumbling hearts. Heart refers to mind. Mind of a person. If the person does not have a strong mind, then easily he or she will be affected by the problems and maybe he or she can put an end to his life. Haven't you seen in newspapers about suicide or people making attempt to suicide?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
ma'am. You might have come across a lot of many such newses. Why does this happen? Why such kind of
depression?
Yes. Not physically strong.
No, physical strength does not matter in this case. But mental strength. Yes. Mentally, they are very, very weak. The people, when they confront a problem, they are not able to withstand it. They are not able to face the problem. They are not strong enough in mind. Okay, so the poet says that wind destroys everything that is weak, whether it is a house or a door or a window or a rafter or trees or bodies, human beings, their lives, minds, everything. Whatever is weak, the wind destroys. And then look at the next line. The wind god winnows and crushes them all. Winnows. What do you mean by the process of, what do you mean by winnowing? Are you familiar with the process of winnowing?
Blow grain and grain.
That's the process of separating grains from the chaff by blowing heavy pressure of air. The process of separating grain from the chaff by blowing air through it. So I'll make it clear with the help of a picture. Winnowing. Here you can see. Okay, winnowing. Different images. Okay, the grains will be separated from the chaff with the help of the wind. The wind god winnows and crushes them all. So here the poet has added the word god along with wind, wind god, to show that it has the supremacy power. Wind god winnows. Wind god separates weak people or weak ones from the stronger ones. And it would crush the weak people, or it would crush, it will break, it will destroy the weak ones. The wind god winnows and crushes them all. So according to the traditional belief, we find that the natural phenomenon, different natural phenomena like wind, sun, air, everything is considered as gods. That is why the poet has used the term wind god, sun god, Surya Bhagavan. Wind god, Vayu Bhagavan, fire god, Agni Devan, and so on. So here, the poet has given wind a supreme power or full authority to show that wind destroys the weaker ones and it separates the weaker ones from the stronger ones. Just like we separate the grain from the chaff, the wind god separates the weaker ones from the stronger ones, and the weaker ones will be crushed. What do you mean by crushing? Crushing means destroying, breaking. Okay, breaking into pieces. Now let's move on to the next lines. Who will read? Anandu, just read.
He want to do what you tell him. So come on, let build strong homes. Let join to door firmly. Practices to frame the body.
Practice to form the body. Make the heart steadfast. Yes. He won't do what you tell him. Who is he referred here? Who is he referred here? Sean? Some of you are not even opening the mouth. It's very difficult to unmute and speak out, isn't it? Oh my goodness. Even if you know the answer, you will not respond. Sean, who is he referred in the line?
Ma'am, wind.
Wind. He won't do what you tell him. Now look at the lines, the first four lines. What did the poet tell the wind? Gauri, what did the poet tell the wind?
Don't scatter the papers.
Don't scatter the papers.
Don't break the shutters of the window.
Don't break the shutters of the windows.
Don't throw the books on the...
Yes, don't throw the books on the shelf. The poet asked the wind not to do this, not to do that. And Justin, did the wind listen to that? Did wind listen to the instructions given by the poet? Justin? No response. Shania?
No, ma'am.
No, the wind did not listen to it. And what did the wind do? Shania, tell me. The wind did not listen to the instructions given by the poet. And what did wind do?
Everything, house and...
Just read those lines. What did the wind do? He did not listen. Instead, he threw all the books down. Then, Please unmute and respond.
Brought rain again.
He brought rain again, and one more thing he did. He tore. Yes, he tore the pages of the books. So Wind did not listen to what poet said. He threw all the books down from the shelf. He tore the pages of the books, and he brought rain again. Okay, so that's why the poet says he won't do what you tell him. Wind will not listen to you. He will do as he wish. So come, let's build strong homes. So let's take precaution in order not to be distracted by the wind. Let's take some precaution. What are the precautions that we have to take? Let's build strong homes. Let's make our houses very strong. Let's join the doors firmly. Let's build a strong door. Practice to firm the body. Firm means, what do you mean by firm? Firm means strong. Let's practice to make our body strong. See, if we don't eat food for many days, what happens?
We will be weak.
Yes, we will be weak. Our body will become weak. And we will be easily affected by some diseases. And we will just... We will be collapsed very soon. Okay, if we don't eat food properly. So the poet says that we have to build up a strong body. If the wind blow harshly, then the weaker ones, the weak people will be carried off easily by the wind. So in order to help or protect ourselves from the destruction of wind, we have to be strong in body. And then the poet says that make the heart steadfast. Steadfast means without change. Steadfast. Without change. We should be not only strong in our body, but we have to be strong in mind also. We have to have strong mind. Imagine that somebody has hurt you very badly. Will you feel sad about it? Somebody whom you love so much has hurt you. Will you feel sad about it? I'm just giving an example.
Yes,
yes or no? Yes or no? Yes.
Ma'am.
Yes. And what happens when you are in a sad status? Will you feel like having food?
No.
We don't feel like eating. Will you feel like going out and play with your friends?
No.
Why you have to think a lot on this? All the answers will be no. Because your mind is upset. Just because you cannot concentrate on what you're doing. You will not be able to study. You will not be able to eat properly. You don't feel like playing outside. Okay. Because your mind has become so weak. Okay, so similarly, the poet says that when your mind becomes weak, you will not be able to concentrate on anything. So it is very important that we have to make our hearts or minds strong enough. Okay, I'll come to the inner meaning later. Let me finish the surface level meaning first. Moving on to the next. Last lines, which conveys very important message. Do this and the wind will be friends with us. What to do?
Form new.
What to do? What are we supposed to do?
Strong.
Yes.
Body.
Yes. We have to be strong. We have to build a strong house. We have to make the doors firm. We have to be strong in body and mind. And if we make ourselves strong, then the wind will be our friend. Wind will not be able to destroy us. Do this and the wind will be friends with us. The wind blows out weak fires. He makes strong fires roar and flourish. His friendship is good We praise him every day. So the final lines are very important. It conveys a very good message. Wind blows out weak fires. No one in this world likes to be a part of a person who is very disappointed, or a person who is always nervous or upset. Am I right? Do you like to befriend someone who has got a very negative thoughts?
No, ma'am.
No, never. We never like to be friendly with a person who has negative thought or negative approach towards life. We never like to be friend with a person who always remain in a sad and depressed state. We never like to be befriend a person who's always nervous and upset. But we expect the friendship of a person who is optimistic, who is very energetic. Am I right? Who always who always keeps a smiling face, who always remains cheerful. Do you agree with my statement?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes. So similarly, the poet says that the wind blows out weak fires. If a candle is lighted, the light produced by the candle will be very small. And if you switch on the fan, will the light remain? Will that light remain on the candle if you switch on the fan? No, because the light is very, very short and it is very weak also. But if a house has been caught by fire and if the wind blows, what happens? Will the wind be able to put off?
And it will make it even stronger.
Yes, yes, exactly. When the wind blows, it will make the fire will be more stronger. Now look at these images. Yes, here you can see how the fire roar and flourish with the help of the wind. Okay? So that's it. So the wind will be able to put off weak fires very fastly, but it will make strong fires roar and flourish. Roar here means emit full flame. Emit full flame, roar. And flourish means to prosper. So if the fire is very strong enough, if the wind blows into that fire, the fire would roar and flourish. It will become more and more. The fire would spread out with its full energy. But if the fire is very weak in its sense, just like if we light a candle, the fire is very short, the weak fire. So if the wind blows out, it can easily put off. Okay. Roar means emit full flame. And his friendship is good. We praise him every day. So the poet is of the opinion that the friendship of wind is very good and we praise him every day. Now, let me ask you, what does the word wind stands for? We have come to the end of the poem. Now we are going to discuss the inner meaning. What does the word wind stands for? The poet was talking throughout, wind destroys the weak ones. Wind promotes stronger ones. So wind is a symbolism of something. Wind symbolizes something. What is that? Who can tell me?
Difficulties in our life.
Yes, very good. Perfect answer, Srihari. Difficulties in our life. Write down in a textbook. Wind symbolizes the difficulties or challenges or adversities in our life. It is very true that we will not be able to live without problems. Problems are part of our life, part and parcel of our life. Every day we come across different problems. We will have to face challenges in our life, no doubt about it. But the poet says that we have to be strong both in body and mind. If we have been hurt by somebody else, we have to forget about it. We have to move ahead. We have to overcome that problem. We have to make our mind strong. Only then we'll be able to lead our life ahead. So wind stands for the difficulties or problems in our life. So if we are strong enough, wind will not be able to destroy. Problems will not be able to destroy us. Okay, problems will not listen to us. When problem come to us, we cannot say that, no, don't come to me, my dear problem. Please spare me. We cannot tell like that. But we have to face boldly. We have to face the problems in a courageous way. We have to take up the challenge. We have to move ahead. So that is why the poet says, the wind blows out weak fires. When problems come, the people who does not have enough strength to face the problems, they will put an end to their life. That is how we find the people committing suicide. The people in a broken state, the people going on to depression, just because they don't have strong mind, they don't have strong willpower, they don't have an energy to overcome the problem. Okay, so the problems, wind stands for problems or difficulties. Now do you understand the meaning of these lines? The wind blows out weak ones. The wind destroys the weak people. It makes strong fires roar and flourish. And if you have to reach to a higher position, if we have to move ahead in our lives, we have to confront problems. If there are no problems, if there are no difficulties, how do we understand that the person is strong enough? If you don't have examination for 9th grade, how can you be promoted to 10th? Very simple example, isn't it? So here, examination is a problem for you. You have to overcome that problem. You have to face that problem. Face with courage. Be brave enough to face all the problems that comes in our life. And if you overcome it, then definitely we can say that the person is strong enough. He makes strong fires roar and flourish. His friendship is good. So each person becomes stronger and stronger when we confront different problems in our life. When we are able to move ahead. When we are able to walk away from something that has hurt us. Okay, and then life becomes meaningful. His friendship is good. We praise him every day. So the title represents the wind. The wind, the title represents the problems or difficulties or adversities that we face in our life. And wind is a symbolism or a symbol of challenges or problems. Okay? So I hope the poem is clear to you.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Any doubts?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so please go through the poem once again. Okay? After the class. When you are free, please go through the poem. And if you have any doubts, please note it in your textbook. And I'll clarify the next class. Next class, we'll be discussing the poetic devices or literary devices that we find in the poem. Okay? All right? Thank you, okay. Children.
Thank you, ma'am.
I'll meet you in the next
session. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am.